I want to follow up on my colleague's line of questioning about PlanCon. You and I both had the privilege of serving on the PlanCon Commission and visiting schools across Pennsylvania. My understanding is that the last date that schools were able to apply for new projects before the moratorium was in March of 2016. Is that correct?
Yes.
Thank you. So we're now in March of 2019, and it's now been 3 years that schools have been unable to apply for new projects because of the moratorium. I'm aware of one public school district in Delaware County that was just days away from getting an application in, didn't make the cutoff, and now they've been waiting in a district that desperately needs school construction funding, as do many of our districts. And the commission that we served on issued a report in May of 2018, but the recommendations have yet to be acted on by the General Assembly. School facility needs are urgent. We heard from my colleague in Philadelphia about the needs there. I remember visiting a school in Philadelphia during the PlanCon hearings that didn't even have running water in its classrooms. And the computers in the school were older than the principal. The need was great, and the facility needs in general was great as well. In southeastern Pennsylvania, including in Delaware County, we had schools that opened at the beginning of the school year and then had to close because of excessive heat warnings, and these were older buildings that did not have air conditioning. It was simply not safe for the children to go to school. So the need for PlanCon is great, and I'm wondering whether you can explain to us why there's no new funding proposed in the 2019-2020 budget.
So historically, when we placed the PlanCon process into a moratorium, we used bond funds to offset the liability or the expense, and that the decision was made at that time to use the bond to draw down projects that were in the queue. The moratorium actually put a freeze or a hold on the process, and we've not been accepting new applications. So you historically, as I understand it, this traditional budget process is not where the governor would make a request for that line item, but it's something that would be done in consultation and in partnership with the General Assembly.
So is the administration supportive of funding PlanCon again?
As our last conversation, the administration is supportive of bringing the recommendations of the commission forward and supporting PlanCon moving forward.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. And I just want to note that the current moratorium expires on July 1st, 2019, so there's a decision again facing the General Assembly about how we're going to tackle this program. I've got a question on another topic. So back in November, the U.S. Secretary of Education, Betsy DeVos, released a rewrite of federal Title IX policy, and it allowed schools to change standards for which evidence would be needed to prove claims of sexual assault and harassment. And we know that the issue of sexual harassment and assault is an issue that unfortunately affects folks at every level, in this building, yes, and also in our colleges and universities, and unfortunately in our K-12 educational institutions as well. Now, when these new guidelines came down, advocates for survivors were concerned that the rule would make it even harder for survivors to experience justice in these cases. How does this ruling affect us here in Pennsylvania, and are there any steps that the department is taking around Title IX guidelines?
So first, I think it's important to use this opportunity to share when the guidance was passed down and forwarded. The governor wrote a scathing letter to the U.S. Department of Education condemning the action of putting victims at risk and potentially making it harder to report incidents of sexual assault and protecting those who are at risk. And I can also share with you that we have the proud distinction here in the Commonwealth to have the first statewide sexual assault program, the It's On Us PA campaign, which the General Assembly and the Governor contributed $1 million a year for the past few years, and we're again asking to continue. As far as we're concerned in the Department of Ed, we are going to continue to put supports in place for sexual assault victims to educate both the victims and create programs on campuses to mitigate instances by which students are put in positions where they're unsafe or unable to report. So we understand what's happening, have been informed around what's happening at the federal level. However, the governor has been championing us and really supporting us to continue to move forward and do what's right. And, you know, to date, we have been receiving that same level of support by the General Assembly in a bipartisan manner.
And I appreciate your leadership and the governor's leadership on this issue. Do we have any statistics? I know that the overwhelming...
Representative, I have to stop you. Your light is on before you can ask another question.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Secretary, I'll follow up in writing. Thank you.
Thank you.